back on Friday Night SmackDown with the Animal.
Single goal, and that goal to really lay a hurting on Shawn Michaels.
And it almost seemed like a threat when General Manager Guerrero said that someone could volunteer to help Batista here tonight.
And I've been looking back, trying to figure out Batista's like threat versus coming through ratio, and it seems to be that Batista has never made a threat that he doesn't follow through on. The man a few words, and when he speaks, we listen.
And his tag team partner.
I don't need a partner.
See? Well, hey. He does not need a partner.
Well, they're the opponents, Ryder and Hawkins, and general manager's in tow.
I cannot for the life of me figure out why those two men are smiling.
Well, because they have a two-on-one handicap matchup.
I don't care. I predict this will be the quickest erasure of two smiles that we've seen here on SmackDown. There it is. False confidence. On display here Friday night. Two men who are fooling only themselves.
Dave? Excuse me, Batista, where's your partner at? Do you have a partner? No partner? Well, then it looks like it's going to be a handicap match.
I don't think you were paying attention. I said, I don't need a partner. I didn't say that I don't have one.
Bye-bye, general manager. Well, no longer.
I believe that Mr. Hawkins and Mr. Ryder have a little date with destiny.
Well, no longer is Pike's Peak the largest thing in Colorado Springs. Because the Big Show.
You don't know how you don't get cold. If they were smiling a minute ago, now those smiles have left. Were they really under the assumption that they were going to be successful against the Animal? This guy's going to rip these two apart.
Well, the ego of Edge is rubbed off, obviously, on Hawkins and Ryder. So we do have ourselves a tag team matchup. Hawkins and Ryder against Batista and the Big Show here on Friday Night SmackDown.
You know, last week on SmackDown, we saw Batista in a very grueling physical matchup with MVP. Perhaps the most aggressive I've ever seen MVP in the ring. Really did a number on the Animal's shoulder. I'm wondering what kind of factor that might play tonight and then Sunday at One Night Stand.
Well, it's Kurt Hawkins who first opened his mouth at the beginning of SmackDown tonight, telling Batista he was being rude, interrupting General Manager Guerrero. Now, this is what Hawkins talking got himself into.
I cannot remember a Batista match that was simply and purely about revenge.
Yeah, most of Batista's matches been against about the world championship over the years. He said earlier this thing with Shawn Michaels has gone beyond personal now.
About as personal as it can get. As I said before, Batista, on the rare occasions he's lost, been very gracious in defeat, but he does not like to be made a fool of, which he feels Michaels made him.
You know, there's so much speculation, so much talk going around about Batista. Or was he embarrassed and upset that he got caught by Shawn Michaels in the feigned injury? Or was he really upset that a man he thought was his friend, Shawn Michaels, lied to him? So many layers to this story as the Big Show comes in off the tag.
Well, Batista takes so much pride in these big matchups, and he really wanted to steal the show. Let's face it, Shawn Michaels is a phenomenal, phenomenal sports entertainer, and he thought they were going to steal the show. It turns out the only thing stolen was Batista's pride.
Hawkins made the tag to Zack Ryder, who has no business in the ring with Big Show, but he's going to have no choice, and Big Show just palmed a full-grown man, lifted a full-grown man like a palm basketball into the ring from the floor. You believe what you just saw? He lifted a grown man
there
off the
floor.
There it is.
Okay. No, I don't believe it until now. I believe it now.
7 feet tall.
I'm a believer.
41 pounds.
Like one of the monkeys. Nesmith or Dolan's. Torque. They're the monkeys. I'm a believer. Come on.
The 1960s.
Wait, I remember you out here with a broadcast partner who used more dated references than that. I'm not talking about the coach either.
Ryder is doing nothing but upsetting Batista, and now Ryder taps in Curt Hawkins.
You know, you still haven't properly thanked me for failing you in that failed coach experiment.
And Hawkins, Batista distracted for the moment. Now Zack Ryder.
Here's a tag to Hawkins. Here's a little food for thought this Sunday. Batista is capable of hurting Michaels immediately. Big offense. We've talked about it time and time again. What will it take for Shawn Michaels to come out on the winning end of this brutal stretcher match?
He's going to have to use his mind again, much like he did at Backlash when he feigned that injury. And keep in mind what we saw on Raw this past Monday night, Nick. Shawn Michaels may be dinged up, may have injured his back in that matchup against Chris Jericho, which could be in Batista's favor.
And if I was Shawn Michaels, I'd have...
Now, if Batista delivers a spinebuster like that someday, he may be able to put Shawn on the stretcher and reel him out of the arena.
And where's that? We've seen a lot of smiles from Batista. Those smiles, I can almost guarantee, will not be in existence this Sunday. Up we go, and down we go.
Choke slam, Batista bomb. The cover. Hawkins and Ryder. Came back Sunday at One Night Stand Extreme Rules. And I'll tell you this, if Batista is as focused Sunday as he was tonight, Shawn Michaels may indeed, in Batista's words, get hurt.
Well, HBK likes to call himself the showstopper at One Night Stand. I think we might want to call Batista the no-stopper because there may well be no stopping him.
Curt Hawkins and Zack Ryder probably shouldn't open up their mouths earlier tonight.
Remember this past Monday, Michaels almost depending on the compassion.
Good teamwork. True teamwork for Big Show and Batista. The choke slam followed by the Batista bomb. And either one of those moves could help either one of those men, Big Show and Batista, win their respective matches Sunday at One Night Stand Extreme Rules.